want to do is take bacteria from these sources. See, this is Bacillus subtilis, this is S. epidermidis, this is E. coli, and you see I've got bacteria that was grown on a slant, bacteria that was grown in a broth, bacteria that was grown on a plate. You see, there's obviously bacteria on this plate, you see? Mm-hmm. And you can see the isolated colonies of E. coli because this is a streak plate. Streak plates are a method of streaking a plate or spreading bacteria on a plate that ends up giving you these isolated colonies, right? So I'm going to show you how to take bacteria from these sources that were already grown on these sources to fresh plate, fresh slant, fresh broth, right? So aseptic technique, the proper way of taking bacteria from here and depositing on here. It's called inoculating, right? We're gonna inoculate fresh media. So when you do aseptic technique, you always have to work near a flame. Because when you have a flame, there's a, this area around the flame where it's relatively sterile, right? Dust and everything moves around, it moves away from that area. So turn on your gas. You see, when I turned on the gas, I didn't hear a hiss. Mm-hmm. And now I'm starting to hear a hiss. What that tells me is, you hear that? And there's more of a hiss. Because if you don't hear a hiss when you turn on the gas, that means something is going on with your Bunsen burner. And usually that something is either this dial isn't, you know, all the way open, or this plate's not down, right? You push the plate and turn it. So anyway, now I hear the hiss. I've got my striker. You push on the striker, click it. You've got your flame. You want your flame somewhere close to your work environment here. Now, what else I want? I want my loop, right? You definitely want to use your loop. Here's your loop. See, don't use the needle. The needle's just the needle, but the loop is meant for this kind of practice. I'll show you what the loop is for later. It's for stabbing agar deeps. So anyway, I always assume there's bacteria on that loop. Should I just go ahead and grab my E. coli right now?
No.
No, because who knows what's on that loop? Remember, bacteria are everywhere. So what I need to do, the first thing you do is flame your loop, right? You put your loop right there over the flame, you get it red hot, and then you gotta wait a few seconds. But notice how I'm not venturing too far away from the flame. I don't get too far away from the flame because that area around the flame is where it's sterile, right? Does that make sense? Now, let's say I want to go from a plate to a broth, right? I'll grab my E. coli plate. I see one colony. I want one of these colonies. Remember the clonal colonies? I can use my hand to open the plate with my thumb, you see? And now that this my loop is cool, open. Touch, very gently touch. That's all I need, just a tiny touch. Put my plate down. I want to go into a broth. The E. coli are on the loop. How do I do this? I only have two hands, right? My pinky. Use my pinky. Remove the cap. Flame. Don't touch anything. Go straight in. Shake, shake, shake. Flame. Replace cap. Done. Now, do I just go throw my loop back into my... I'm done?
No,
because there's thousands upon thousands of E. coli on this loop right now, right? Mm-hmm. So I have to flame it. Otherwise, if I just put it back in there, I'm contaminating stuff like you wouldn't believe, right? So the first thing you do is flame. The last thing you do is flame every single time. Now, let's say I'm talking to you and, you know, I hit my loop on something. Do I just still assume it's sterile?
Mm-hmm.
No. If my loop hits anything at all, even my glove for a second, I have to flame it again, right? Does that make sense? You guys need to know this as medical professionals. Something ceases to be sterile once it has been out in the air too long, once it has touched something briefly, once you've spat on it, you know, it's not sterile. All right, so now you see you went from a plate to a broth. Let's go from a slant, you know, a slant to a slant. I don't know. Let's do that. So this is a slant of Bacillus subtilis. Again, what do? I only have two hands. Grab it with my pinky. And I just flamed, right? So if I can't remember if I flamed or not, what do?
Flame.
Just when in doubt, flame it out, is what I say. You know, I have a saying, right? When in doubt, flame it out. It never gets you in trouble to flame again, right? Does that make sense? Then wait a few seconds. You know why? If you don't wait a few seconds, you'll go to try to get some sample and you'll hear it. You know what that is?
You're kidding.
Stuff dying, right? Because it's too hot, right? Does that make sense? So again, you use your pinky, you flame real quick, you go into the slant, and here's the thing, you don't want to stab stuff, you just want to touch the bacteria on top. Just touch them, that's it, no stabbing. Flame again, put the cap on again. Now I've got bacteria on there, I want to put it on this slant. And do you know the proper way of inoculating a slant? You put the, you go all the way down, touch the agar, and then make a straight road up. It's kind of tricky, but you can do it. So here's what you do. You take the cap off, flame. Don't touch anything. Go all the way to the bottom, all the way to the bottom. Then touch the agar and go straight up. You see that? Like a road, a straight road. Replace the cap. Place it here. What do I do now?
Flame
it. First and last thing you do every single time is flame. That's how you properly inoculate a slant. And how do I make a streak plate, right? A streak plate. Remember, you want to make a streak plate so you find isolated colonies, right? The best way to do that is, let me show you. So you've got your plate, right? You want to have three zones. So if you're a beginner, on the bottom side of your plate, you can make a line and then another line, kind of like a T, right? Kind of like a T, like this. This is, the biggest zone is going to be zone one, and then you're going to have zone two and three, right? So you start with zone one. What do I do in zone one? I'll make a line and then go across that line all over it, right? And that's going to be where most of my bacteria are. But am I going to get single colonies there?
Mm-hmm.
No. But I'll eventually get to single colonies. Let me show you how it works. So again, I think I may have hit something, so I flame it out. We're almost done. So I flame it out, let it cool a little. I go to my E. coli. Do I just grab a huge chunk of E. coli from wherever?
No.
No, I want grab one of these little colonies. So again, what do? I just touch one colony, tiny bit. I don't need the whole colony. I just need a little bit of it, right? And then I go to my plate and watch this. I open it up. I very gently make a line in that big zone. And then I go left, right, 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 right? So that's my zone. My first zone is done. I'm not going to get isolated colonies in that zone, right? That's the big zone, right? Now, guess what I need to do? I need to flame. I need to flame because I want to kill all these bacteria. Because guess what? What I'm going to do now is take bacteria, drag it from the first zone into the second zone. Does that make sense? I'm not gonna go back into the E. coli stock. Look, right now there's no bacteria on here. Now when I go into zone one, I pick up some bacteria. I go into zone one twice and then never again. Do you guys follow that?
Mm-hmm.
And then I flame again. So that should have diluted. Zone two should have fewer bacteria. I may or may not get single colonies in zone two. So now I'm going to zone three, watch. So again, there are no bacteria on my loop, but when I go into zone two twice, I pick up some bacteria and then I never go back into zone two. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So zone three, and then I flame again, right? Zone three should have the fewest bacteria, and that's where I should see isolated colonies. And that's why, see, now everything's flamed. I can actually turn off my flame. And that's why you see, like on a plate like this, you see this E. coli plate, you'll see that's zone one, right, with where you can't see any isolated colonies. That's zone two, which has fewer bacteria, but you can't see any colonies. And then see zone three? That's where you got the colonies, because it's got most concentrated, less and less, right? And that's aseptic technique. That's how you properly conduct that kind of inoculation. Right.
Cool.
Thanks, guys.